Hello and welcome back to Horror Month 2014. Only it's not Horror Month this month. It's what, Vince?
Halloween month.
It is Halloween month because Vince and I will be reviewing the box set of all the Halloween movies all month long.
Because you really wanted us to do that, didn't you?
Oh yeah, we had tons of requests to do this.
Oh yeah, tons of them. Great big whole stacks of requests.
So now we are on to Halloween 2.
There it is, in all its glory.
Yeah, I've always loved this cover, and I'm glad, you know, that every one of these covers actually has the cover from the movie on it. And that is such a classic cover for the Halloween franchise. Love the pumpkin and the skulls. I've always loved that cover.
And of course, once again, they put them on the discs themselves. See, the discs themselves?
And on the back of the disc, you can see there is a ton of extras on this disc. And also, we should mention that there are two discs that come with this box set. One is the movie, the other one is the TV version. Now, we also should mention what, Vince?
One of them is Blu-ray, and one of them is DVD.
No, we should mention that we've already done this review, and basically, we are going to show you the review that we've already done.
Is this some kind of joke? I've been trick-or-treated to death tonight.
You don't know what death is.
The Halloween 2 is exactly the same as the previous Scream Factory release.
Oh, yeah, I guess we should mention that.
So the rest of the review, if you've watched it before, you're going to see it again. But if you haven't seen it before, you'll be seeing it for the first time.
Exactly. And who wouldn't want to do that?
Let's roll it.
Halloween 2. More of the night he came home.
All right, so let's get right into, first, the picture quality, Vince. What'd you think?
Actually, I have to say it was really good. It was clear. I think it was the clearest and that this movie has ever looked.
Yeah, I agree. I think the picture quality here is pretty excellent on the Blu-ray. I don't think it's the best transfer I've ever seen. But for Halloween 2, yeah, it looks as good as it probably ever will. Now, the audio was pretty decent here. But it wasn't spectacular either. I mean, it was okay. I don't think it had an incredible surround sound to it.
Yeah, I think the audio could have been a little bit better.
And now let's get into the extras. First, we have two commentaries here. The first commentary is by the director. It does have the actor that's with him. I believe he was Bud in the movie, the guy that played Bud.
And this will be our introduction now to Jamie Lee after we left her in the first film, with the stab wound in her shoulder. So, came off the, and let me stop for a minute. There's the introduction of Leo Rossi and Lance Guest.
I look like my son. look at that. You know what I think when I see that? 33-inch waist. Oh boy, that's all right.
The commentary isn't all that great. I mean, it's not terrible, but it's the type of commentary where they'll stop talking for like a minute and a half. You know, you're like watching the movie, and they're talking and talking, and all of a sudden they just stop talking. And there's this big, long space, and you're like, okay, did I hit a button? What's going on? And then all of a sudden they start talking again. I'm like, and for me, that doesn't really make entertaining commentary. And the second commentary, which is on the back of the box, and it says it's by the guy who played Michael Myers, the stunt coordinator. But he's also with another person, like the director is. And I believe the other person like runs some kind of horror website and some magazine or something. I don't know who the guy was.
Because I remember catching this on TV as opposed to on videotape. And I'd always notice different versions of scenes.
Uh-huh.
This is to keep with the Halloween tradition. A little kid biting down on piece of candy with a razor. This always kind of disturbed me as a kid too.
Yeah, that's Ty Mitchell, and I now see him as a handsome young guy at the conventions. That's the only scene he was in, but it's memorable, I think.
Yeah.
So if you only have time to watch one commentary, watch the one with Michael Myers, because he talks about you know, really, you wouldn't think it would be that interesting because he's just a stunt coordinator. But yeah, he actually talks more about making the films than the director does.
That's probably because they have Michael Myers in just about every scene of this movie. So I can imagine that Dick Warlock would have been like all over that commentary.
Now, the television version, unfortunately, is not in Blu-ray. But at the same time, I don't think it affected the movie at all. I thought it still looked pretty clear.
Yeah, I think it did too. I think it actually did look well. And for being the TV version, it did look superior. Because whenever they do show it on television, it's usually, like I said before, dark. And you can't really tell what's going on.
And you may not think there's a big difference between the theatrical version and the TV version, but let me tell you, there's a huge difference. It's almost like watching an entirely different film.
Julie saw him, you know. Michael Myers.
Come on.
I swear, yesterday when she was coming to work.
What did she see?
You know the shopping bag out by the mall? Well, she stopped at a light and saw him walking in that field behind the Lost River Diamond. Julie said he was so creepy.
Julie's full of sugar. Didn't escape until last night.
Damn. You don't have to swear, but...
Right, exactly. They added a lot of extra footage and a lot of extended footage.
Just like alternate shots of the same sequence, too, which is really weird.
Well, next we have The Nightmare Isn't Over, The Making of Halloween 2.
Not long after, Bob Raimi at NBC announced that he was going to do The Fog with John Carpenter. I was pretty upset. I was livid. I called Carpenter and I got nowhere with him. And I did the only thing I could at that point. I sued them both.
Before I saw this, I literally have never seen anything about Halloween 2. I've never seen a single documentary about it. I've never seen anyone ever talk about it. I've never seen any making of it.
I'd say it'd be the same thing for me. I mean, I haven't really... I mean, I saw some behind-the-scenes footage here and there, but I've never seen anything like this. And this whole featurette, this whole behind-the-scenes making of is really actually very entertaining and very interesting because they get almost the whole cast. Horror's Hallowed Grounds, the locations of Halloween 2.
We're standing behind 716 Meridian. This is actually the Elrod House. What happens is there's a point of view shot. It's supposed to be Michael's point of view coming from their yard. He comes this way, looking down the alley here. He then turns, and when he turns, there's a jump cut. So it jumps to a shot of a dog barking, and then you'll notice this pole in the background with the X on it. The pole next to it's a newer pole that wasn't there before. The point of view shot then follows Michael this way, down the alley, and then he sees Loomis and Sheriff Brackett pull up in the car there.
This was really interesting. It was basically a guy walking around Haddonfield, or where they filmed it, it was supposed to be Haddonfield, and showing all the houses now, you know, what they look like now compared to when they filmed the movie. And he's like walking up and down the alleyways where they show everything and going to the VA hospital. And I thought it was pretty good.
And it was interesting to see all these places that you've seen this many times and so many times on television and now on DVD and Blu-ray. It makes me want to go to those places.
What's really interesting is they look almost exactly the same as they did when they filmed the movie. And then the house with an old woman in the beginning of it. Yeah, that house is still there. It's exactly the same. It has, like, not been touched. They even have the cutting board she pulls out where the knife is on it. It's still there. They haven't touched anything in the house. So up next, we have the deleted scenes. Unfortunately, all these deleted scenes that are on this disc are actually the same exact deleted scenes that are on the other disc from the TV version of it. However, what does make this worth watching is to have the director's commentary over the deleted scenes, so it's worth watching to see what he thinks about the scenes that were cut from the film.
So I always liked this scene. I thought it had a certain tension, and anytime you have needles and clothes coming off, that's a good scene for a horror film, I think.
We have the TV and radio spots. really kind of interesting to watch the TV spots, but the radio spots, that was even more entertaining.
The lights go out. The phone goes dead. The stairs creak.
Who's there?
The doorknob turns. And you're all alone.
Finally, we have the still gallery, which are still pictures from the movie and the set.
And this was pretty cool. This is actually the behind-the-scenes things that I had seen throughout the years. Overall, I would have to say I actually enjoyed it. It's better than any version of Halloween 2 I've ever seen.
So in all, I would have to give Halloween 2 a definite 5 out of 5.
This is my rating. 5 out of 5.
All right, there you go. There is our review for Halloween 2. And I would say that it still holds up. My opinion that I had for this, you know, when we reviewed it for the first time, is exactly the same.
There's only slight differences to it, as is packaging, obviously. And I think the menu's just slightly different. There's something happens like right before the actual menu pops up. They show like a quick Halloween 2 kind of thing. And that's probably the only difference on these discs that there is.
And if you did not pick up Halloween 2, the Scream Factory version of it, you will love this. I guarantee you. Because, like I said in the review, is I never knew anything about Halloween 2 before I started watching this. And now I know pretty much everything about Halloween 2.
Exactly. And I love it. I loved it then. I love it now. Halloween 2 is actually one of my favorite sequels out of the whole Halloween series. My opinion's still the same as it was last year, or the year before, when we reviewed it.
One thing that makes it so fun, and they hardly ever do it anymore with sequels, is it took place right when the first one ended. I mean, literally, right when Michael falls out the window, this movie starts. There's no, you know, in between here. It's basically a continuation of the first film. And I love that. I mean, they don't hardly ever do. They did it with Friday the 13th Part 4, and that's one of the things I love about that, too. But I always love it when a horror film does that, and they did it so well. It's like Part 1 and Part 2 is basically one long film.
Exactly. It's
more of the night he came home.
Yeah, absolutely great. My opinion still stands. Love this, and, you know, what else is there to say?
Stay tuned for Halloween 3, Season of the Witch.
Yep, we will be reviewing that next. So make sure you go to our Facebook. We will put a link below and like it. And make sure you subscribe to our site so you don't miss any exciting Halloween footage.
Because it's Halloween month, all horror month, October 2014 long.